11 and a half gone, opening period, a 10-2 shot advantage for the Ducks as Gibson fires it over the glass, and the Leafs will have a power play.
Well, John Gibson's nose, you know, it's a rolling puck. And goaltenders, where you got that big catching glove and that heavy goal stick, you don't have a great feel for the puck, so he just kind of swats this. But he just airmails it, and that wasn't even close. That was way over top of the glass. So, boy, the Ducks have played a terrific game so far. One of the things they were looking to avoid was to put this potent Toronto power play on the man advantage, and here we go.
In the game in Toronto a month ago, the Leafs were 2-for-5 on the power play. They're seventh in the league.
The Stars, strangely enough, only have 4 wins this year when being tied at second intermission. They're going to be shorthanded for the second time tonight here on an interference call in the Flames' opening minute.
Well, they slapped Sagan and Ben back together to start this third period, and the Senators almost make this a 3-2 hockey game. Brady Tkachuk goes to the far post. He's stuffed by Anton Khudobin. And as it carries on, little grab by Khudobin on the arm of Tkachuk. And with that, the Senators head to the power play.
Now Toronto's in trouble, and the Penguins haven't played them yet. They have a home and away coming up. Look out!
Right in front, Cirelli tripped up, couldn't get the shot off, and a penalty will be called against Pittsburgh. Matt Murray sprawled out in the crease. Cirelli hits the deck.
Should that be a penalty shot? Just it's a question I'm posing to you more than
trivia.
Yeah, it's a little more than that. I just think you're man on man. There's nobody there. You're tripped by the goalie.
And he's going to put that puck
in. He's wide open. He's going to put it into wide open net if he doesn't get tripped. It's really a good play by Matt Murray at the end of the day. Just some food for thought. The Penguins will have to kill this power play. Maybe a shorty turn it around here. The referee with a conversation, Matt Murray.
In the last 2 games, they have won 3 straight. Elias Pettersson skates toward the net. He gets tripped up, hauled down. That'll be a penalty. He skated in alone. What do we have?
Might be a penalty to the goalie. I didn't see any other signal. Sidney Crosby's asking what happened here, and Gensel's going into the box.
Pittsburgh penalty number 1, tripping.
Well, it didn't take long for Elias Pettersson to make a name in this game for himself. He really looked like he had frozen netminder with the pump, moved it to the forehand. I think without the trip, it's a goal for Pettersson, who's going to put it into that net with that long, rangy body of his, Mercy. Wow, this guy is tall and thin.
In drag move, Gallagher is trying to pull it back for the wrist shot. That was broken up by Jonas Brodin in time. And once again, play whistle down, and Granlund comes on the ice. We have too many men.
I'm not sure.
Honor penalty for playing the puck outside trapezoid.
Okay. I was wondering.
When you see a call that you don't see very often, you're counting guys on the ice and you're looking in every direction, but the whistle came at an unusual time. So as that puck comes down, watch the handle. At the start, it's fine, but it bounces over Price's stick, and that is really close. If you're looking at the plane and thinking about football and the plane of the goal line, and did the ball go across the plane, that puck was in the air. Price didn't argue very much. I think when he sees it on a replay, he is going to argue very much.
Slot for Adrian. The perfect slot is third line centerman, but he's got to be more productive at the same time, but he's bringing that edge.
Adrian had to miss the last game day-to-day. It's going to be a penalty here against the Kings, and it's a roughing penalty in the corner.
Little discussion right there. Jonathan Quick talking with Garrett Rank. It's on Quick because the referee gave the old twirl of the hand, meaning it has to be someone off the ice. Someone who's on the ice for the Kings has to serve the penalty. So roughing, something happening around the crease, trying to protect your environment. In behind the net, a little bit of he thought a shove, so he turns around and gives him a shove. Not much at all. Now, I think what the referee thought happened there was that he made contact with the blocker. That was not the case. It wasn't a punch, it wasn't a jab, it was more of a push and a shove. So it was the same thing both ways. Unfortunately for the Kings, the referee saw only quick, or he assumed something else happened, because those were love taps more than anything else. So
Randy Love turns and guns it. Aho got in front of that. Now it's Ben. Ben to Seguin. Oh, he was tripped up. There's going to be a penalty here. A slashing call.
It's these two that got involved in the first period, because you remember that Mrazek lost his stick and Seguin knocked it out of harm's way. No call on that one.
Carolina with 34, Monitor Penalty hooking.
And that is, it's an unneeded penalty from Mrazek. And picture tells the story that he got him between the legs. And that's the only chink in Peter's armor. But sometimes when a goalie takes a penalty that he knows he's responsible for, and you won't see a better example than that. And he knows he has to dial in and be the most important penalty killer. Williams will serve it. Somebody on the ice has to.
That usually garners a cheer from the faithful at Honda Center.
Gibson out to Plant in a collision that Gibson takes exception to, and now his teammates will do the taking exception for him. I don't believe there was a penalty call coming up here.
This went out. Gibson plays the puck. You know what? Looking at it from that angle, John Gibson also contributed to the contact a little bit, I would say.
And then he finishes the contact.
Yeah.
Walks into the net. That's off the mark. And Matthias Ekholm. Little slap pass comes in front. Look out. And knocked away by Tyler Bozak, and a penalty called by the referee at center ice as Watson was upended.
Binnington's going to get the call.
St. Louis penalty number 50, 2 minutes for roughing.
It's going to get Binnington the roughing call here.
Wow.
We'll take a closer look. We saw how active Binnington was in that first period, just trying to stir up some energy, and he's good at that. But Austin Watson in front of the net there is poking away. That puck was loose. He pokes away, and Austin Watson leans into him. You can see that Binnington, I would do the same thing. Austin Watson comes into the crease, and he's kind of giving him just a little bit of enough of a shove. That kind of stuff like that usually just goes, the referee goes and gives you a little bit of a warning. I was talking to Austin Watson this morning. I said, you ever watch Peaky Blinders? I said, you look like Arthur.
Both teams engineering a change with less than seven to go here in the opening period. Hutton is out to flip it away, and it's going to be called.
There's a penalty coming here.
Yeah.
And we'll wait and see what the call is going to be. Carter Hutton outside the trapezoid, playing the puck.
Doesn't happen often, that call.
You don't hear that very much at all, and Carter Hutton's not disputing it. Let's take a look and see what he shows us right here.
Yep.
Yeah, the puck is outside. He reaches in, or reaches out, I should say. Nevertheless, doesn't matter. Detroit Red Wings, 2 for the last 13 on the power play, ranked 29th in the NHL. And they have given up 11 shorthanded goals this year, and that is 31st in the NHL in that department.
Back inside, Cam Talbot reaches back, and that is whistled down, and nobody is happy now. It's Inke Gagne with a late poke, and look out as Talbot is into it, and he wants a piece of somebody back there.
Gagne's coming back at Giordano, and now Giordano's coming up too. This thing blew over in a hurry.
And Smith is coming up to center ice as this thing comes unglued.
And Bear in the high slot here fighting, looks like with Matthew Tkachuk.
It's Tkachuk and Bear, and they are trading them. Bear comes over the top of the right. Tkachuk comes back, and now Talbot and Mike Smith are going to go as center ice. Talbot and Smith, who've been on both sides of this Battle of Alberta. This is unbelievable.
Wow. Both guys played for the other team, respectively, the year before in the Battle of Alberta. They're going against each other. And Mike Smith came right to center. Talbot said, you know what? Let's do this. defense just keeps getting better and better. I'll tell you, just a little jab by Gagne after. That puck looked like it was still a little bit loose. It went into the back of the net, and they took exception of it, the Flames did, and started to pounce on Gagne, and then everybody converged in, and it boiled over in a millisecond. And shrapnel on the ice right there.
It is a yard sale out there, and the people in this building can't believe what they just saw.
Well, there it is there, and Talbot lays down on his back, and it was underneath him, but Gagne jams through under the armpit. They take exception, everybody comes in, including Talbot, and then a couple shots unanswered by Gagne on Giordano. He looks like he gets up, and he's not too happy about that, and then Tkachuk separates with Bear, and they go out and had a pretty good doozy tilt, too. Both of them got some shots in. Ethan Bear's first scrap in the NHL. With this thing, the three-goal lead, we talked about it. Could this thing boil over with the history this year, especially carried over from last year in the Battle of Alberta? And then, you know what? Mike Smith standing center, and Cam Talbot looks up the ice and says, you know what? Let's keep this thing going. And they go at it, had a pretty spirited tilt, too. Two big guys, too. You look at both of these guys off the ice. They're not your typical goaltenders. Talbot's a big dude, took a couple rights there. He comes back with one, and then as they go down, good job by Smith to pull up and not continue to wail away. But two big guys off the ice, too. They have at it, too. But yeah, obviously, we're going to see a couple different goaltenders in between the pipes for both teams.